Hello students, welcome to lecture of kinematics and theory of machine. Myself Professor Shailesh Patel, and we are going to continue synthesis of mechanism. And in this chapter we are going to complete the relative pole method, and we will synthesis the four bar and single slider mechanism by relative pole method. Okay, let's start. The input data will be this: link number 1, link number 2, link number 1, link number 2 will be given. Inputs angle theta, theta 1, 2, theta 1, 3. This is are the input angle, means as the link number 1 will move, this is are the inputs angle. And 5, 1, 2 and 5, 3 is output angle. As you know that this link move, this output angle will be changed. And after using this synthesis, we are going to obtain this data, link number, length of link number 3 and link number 4, and output angle, initial output angle, you can find this. So these three data we will find after using this relative pole method. Okay, and it is three positions, same type of inversion for the two position is there, and you have to study. Okay, let's start. So first of all, we are going to start with this link number 1, link number 2 and theta, initial angle. These three data we will use. As you know that link number 1, we will draw link number 2 at this angle is a theta. Okay, so after that we are going to use theta 1, 2 and phi 1, 1, 2 with at the same time. Theta 1, 2, how we will use theta 1, 2? First of all, we have to measure this theta 1, 2 by 2 angle at here. You can see here, I am giving you an example. If theta 1, 2 is 40, then you have to make here angle only 20. Okay, remember that half angle means half angle of theta 1, 2 we will make here, and we will draw this line here, theta 1, 2 by 2. And same we will do here, phi 1, 2 by 2. We will measure this angle here, phi 1, 2 by 1, 1, 2 by 2, and make this line from passing through the D. And it will give us here point P 1, 2. Okay, which point? P 1, 2 point. How we can get this point? Theta 1, 2 by 2 and phi 1, 2 by 2. So we will get P 1, 2. And same we will do with theta 1, 3 and phi 1, 3. We are going to make angle theta 1, 3 by 2 and make this line passing through the A. And same here, phi 1, 3 by 2 and line passing through the, and point at which these two line intersect, we will get here this P 1, 3. And now what we are going to use, this P 1, 2 and P 1, 3. So check this. First of all, I will connect this P 1, 2 here and measure the angle which is here. I am using this angle and applying here same angle, whatever the angle, if I find this angle as a 25. So I will make same angle here 25. Okay, remember that we are repeating relative pole, means whatever angle is here, we are going to same angle here, and I will make this line, and I don't know the distance. Okay, right now, and same will complete with here also P 13. What I am going to do, connect this P 13 to this initial position B, and whatever the angle is here, I will measure the angle here and apply same angle with this initial position here, and I will get this line, which is also, I don't know the length, but this two line intersecting at a point here C. And when I connect these two lines, two links with a B, C and B, I will get this four bar chain mechanism. Okay, so this is the three position synthesis of the four bar by relative pole method. I am going to repeat this and draw this. Okay, let's start. Remember that whatever the given data, first of all, link number 1, link number 2 and theta, I am using that data. So, okay, link number 1 and at a point at link number 2, angle will be theta. We know that. So, link number 1, link number 2 and theta. After that, what I am going to do? At theta 1 2 angle given, but I will make here theta 1 2 by 2. Angle will be theta 1 2 whatever given by 2, and line will be like this here. Okay, and same I will complete here at the end, and this line I will draw like this. Consider point is here. And the angle with horizontal, you already know, 512 by 2 is 512 by 2. So always remember that in this case, in relative pole, always we divided the all angle theta 12 by 2 here, and this point you know that is a P12. And what we are going to P12, so we are going to connect this P12 here with initial, and whatever the angle we measure here, we apply here and make this line like this, and we don't know the length of this line. Okay, and now start with for the third position. I'm going to change the color. Theta 13 by 2, angle measure from the initial position like theta 13 by 2. Going to draw the line same as for here at output. I am going to measure here the some angle 513 by 2, and I am going to make line passing through the D, and it will intersect at some point here with this line like this. And what I am going to do, first of all, connect this point to the initial position. Initial position means the starting means end of the crank, and same angle which I have measured here, I apply here and draw the line here like this. And whatever the point, these two, second position and third position, will intersect, it will be our final point is a C. Okay, and I am going to connect these two points with here and here. So this is your data. We want to find link number 3, link number 4, and if you measure here this angle, this will be 5. Okay, so that's it. This is the 3 position synthesis of 4 bar, and now we are going to 3 position synthesis of single slider by relative pole method. And in this case, same you can see here, this data is given, eccentricity theta 12, theta 13 and distance. But check this, how we are going to obtain this. So in this case, we are not making the slider position. In this, we are going to make crank position 12 and 13 here. So check this. First of all, make the some two lines at eccentricity A, means two random lines. First make random line, and then measure the distance E is given, and make second line. So that's how you will get these two lines. Okay, first is a line of motion of piston, and second is a position on for the crank. Okay, make the initials. This point will be randomly, and this second point is randomly. These two point we have to take randomly. So I am repeating again what you have to do. First make two lines at a distance eccentricity E is given. So this two line, and then to this initial position of crank center and piston center, these two random points you can take at any point. And after that, let's start the synthesis. How we can do this? So first of all, this distance is given, this distance S12 and S13 is given. So what we are going to do, from the center of crank we are making these lines first at a distance of S12/2 and S13/3. Whatever distance is given, if it is 100, we are making this perpendicular line, make a very light line because it is not for drawing, it is for the reference. Okay, so S12/2 and S13/3, two lines. And after that we are going to use θ12 and 13. Okay, how? So now θ12/2, we are going to make angle with this perpendicular here, and we are going to first second position here at angle, this angle will be θ12/2. And same as in 4 bar, what we are going to do, connect this to initial position or center of the slider and measure this angle. You can check this angle, we have to measure and we have to apply here same angle, and whatever the angle is here, we apply here and make this line. Okay, we don't know the length here right now. Okay, and same will we repeat with the third position. What we are going to do, we will measure this angle θ13/2 and draw the position of this and this line. And this line, whenever this line intersecting our S13/2 perpendicular line, this point will be P13, and we have to connect this point to the initial position, and we have to measure this angle here, and same angle we will apply here, and we again connect this point, and this two line means intersecting at a end of crank. Okay, this is more difficult than 4 bar. So let's check how can we make this. I'm repeating total method again. So first of all, make one line, and parallel to that at eccentricity E, I'm making this second line. Distance between these two line will be E, eccentricity. So after that I am going to take any point for the crank center and any second point on this eccentric line at for the slider center. So I am making this slider here. After that I am going to make here three perpendicular line which will be at a first will be at a center of crank, and after that I am making this line which distance S12/2. This distance will be S12/2, and same again third line at a distance S13/2. Remember that the three perpendicular line we have to make with this baseline. So this S12/2 is here and S13/2 is here. And after that what I am going to do, erase this line. Okay, this here. So first of all we are making the crank here. Crank I am going to make here, but at which angle? This, check this θ12/2. Okay, so I am going to measure here θ12/2 and making this line, and I am going to, at which length? First of all, the length will be at a point when this line intersecting with this perpendicular line. Okay, whatever the length. So I am connecting to that, and this point will be I given P12, and connecting this point with the initial, I will measure this angle, and measured from this line, same angle I measured from this line, and will draw line here. I don't know the length right now, and same I will complete with this second position θ13. I know that θ13 is here. Measure angle θ13/2 here. Remember that θ13/2, and making this line up to which line point whenever this line, my crank line will intersecting this perpendicular line, okay, and I know I want this point as a P3, and connecting this point with the initial, measuring this angle here and applying same angle to this line, and whenever I draw this line here, whatever the point, it will give me the length of crank and connecting, okay,